نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Indeed, all praises due to Allah. We praise Him, seek His aid, and ask His forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah from the evils of ourselves and from the evils of our actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, none can lead astray. And whomsoever Allah leads astray, none can guard. I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except for Allah alone, have no partner. And I bear witness that Muhammad is His slave and His messenger. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullaha haqqa tuqatih wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. O you who believe, fear Allah as He should be feared. Die not except in a state of Islam with complete submission to the Almighty. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُم مِّن نَّفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا وَبَثَّ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً ۚ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي تَسَاءَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامَ ۚ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَيْكُمْ رَقِيبًا. O mankind, be dutiful to your Lord who created you from Adam, a single person. And from him he created his wife, Hawa, and may peace and blessings be upon both of them. And from them both he created many men and women. And fear Allah, through whom you demand your mutual rights. And do not cut the relations of your relatives. Surely Allah is ever on all watch over you. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu attaqullaha wa qulu qawlan sadida. O you who believe, keep your duty to Allah and speak always the truth. He will direct you to do righteous good deeds. يغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. But he obeys Allah and His Messenger, then he has indeed achieved a great achievement, and that is he will be made to enter paradise and he will be saved from the hellfire. عباد الله, to proceed, فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. The best of talks, beyond any doubt, is the Quran. وأحسن الهدي, and the best of guidance, the guidance of His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And verily the most evil of all matters are the ones innovated. فَإِنَّ كُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ. For every new and innovated matter in Islam is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. And every innovation in Islam is a misguidance. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. And every misguidance will lead to the hellfire. As we have discussed, walhamdulillah, in our previous khutbah, a hadith which was narrated by two followers from a companions. We said from Abdul Rahman ibn Amr al-Sulami and Hujr ibn Hujr, whom are from the era of the followers that came after the generations of the companions, that they have come to Al-Irbad ibn Sariyah, whom they have believed that he is one of those people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had sent. The revelation in Surah At-Tawbah, وَلَا عَلَى الَّذِينَ إِذَا مَا أَتَوْكَ لِتَحْمِلَهُمْ قلت لا أجد ما أحملكم عليه تولوا وأعينهم تفيض من الدمع حزنا ألا يجدوا ما ينفقون. And then they came to him, to Al-Irbad, and they said, Assalamu alaikum. And we explained the virtues and the importance of saying salam, saying the salam is the key to paradise. Then they said to him, we came to visit you. And we said to the importance, and we talked about the importance of paying a visit to the brothers in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not for anything else except that you love the brother for the sake of Allah. And then they said, we know that you are ill, so we came to pay you a visit because you're ill. And we talked about the merits and the excellence of visiting a person who is ill. Then they said, wa muqtabisin. And also we came to learn, and we spoke about the importance of the knowledge. For verily the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِرِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ فَارْتَعُوا. If you pass by the posture of Jannah, then make sure that you graze there. You stay there. Messenger of Allah, what is the Riyadu al-Jannah? What is the posture of Jannah? He said, حِلَقُ الذِّكْرِ. The circles of knowledge. When there is a circle of knowledge, then there is something there to take as a benefit. And Riyadu jam' rawdah. And the riyad is a plural of the word rawda. And the Prophet ﷺ, he said, between my pulpit and my house, rawdatun min riyad al-jannah. There is a posture from the land of Jannah. People, they fight one another For that land which is between the pulpit of the Prophet of Allah and the house of the Prophet of Allah, in the masjid of the Prophet of Allah, where the green carpet is. Yes, maybe it's correct, but they do fight. And number two, after that, when they pray the two rak'ah, they stay there and make i'tikaf. That's not from the sunnah. Not only that, every time they come to the masjid, they are eager to go to that posture, which is not from the sunnah. Yet the Prophet of Allah is telling those people who are keep going to that rawdah, if you went to the Riyadh, which is more of importance, that is the circles of knowledge, you would have learned the etiquette of coming to that posture, which is between the pulpit of the Prophet of Allah and the house of the Prophet of Allah. Ibadallah. When Al-Irbad ibn Sariyah had heard these two followers, had said what they had said, so he wanted to honor them. Because they said, we came muqtabiseen. We want to learn from you. We came to listen to what you have heard from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the knowledge. This is the thing that every person should be keen to learn. Not the chit-chat that takes you nowhere except to gossiping or to backbiting, and that would lead you to the hellfire. Ibadallah, they said, we want to learn, and Al-Irbad is now about to honor them. He said, wa'adana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam maw'idatan dharafat minha ad-dumu' wa wajilat minha al-qulub. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advised us, he admonished us, and that is a maw'idah, an admonishing which is very eloquent, touching the heart. And maw'idah, a reminder from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the extent that our eyes were overflowing with tears. And not only that, our heart were tremored with fear. This is the eloquence of the words of the Prophet of Allah. Because the Messenger of Allah is not one like us. He says about himself, "Utitu jawami al-kalim." Are we being given the words which are few in number, they are vast in meanings? One word of the Prophet of Allah needs for new pages to explain and interpret. The Prophet of Allah's words, they are straight to the heart, and they should be the case. So if it did not make an effect in you, then there is something wrong here, brother. In the heart of yours, the physician, the GP is not your target. It's actually your target has come to the circles of knowledge to fix that heart in order to respond to the words of Allah, not to do what the people had told others. For verily, if you want to train yourself, every time you hear a verse to cry, is to make qiyam and exert yourself. Work hard to make sure that you are crying. What are you going to do? You're going to shout crying? You're going to put an act to cry? The cry has to come from the heart. It's not an act you're going to put. You're going to become an actor? Those actors, they cry for whatever the reason it is. You're a person who your heart should be moved by the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Moved by the words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So the Messenger of Allah, he had made this eloquent speech. And that eloquent speech had an effect on the hearts. Companions were shedding tears. And it's not the only time when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says something, the companions are in tears. One day, Abu Huraira narrates for us that the Prophet of Allah came out to a raht. Raht means a group from 3 to 10. A raht from the companions. They were laughing. They were chit-chatting. So the Prophet ﷺ, he said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ. By the one in whose hand is my soul. لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ مَا أَعْلَمُ. If you know what I know, لَضَحِكْتُمْ قَلِيلًا. You would have laughed but little. وَلَبَكَيْتُمْ كَثِيرًا. And you'd have wept a lot. Then he left them. And the companions started crying. Until there's a sound of khaneen coming out of them. Khaneen. They're trying to digest the sound of the sort of cry. But there's a khaneen. There's groaning. For verily, Allah the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, inspired to his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ya Muhammad, O Muhammad, lima tuqannit ibadi? Why are you making my slaves in despair? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went back to the companions. And he said to them, abshiru, have a glad tiding. That means have a glad tiding, even as little as giving a half a date in charity. You might save yourself from the hellfire. So don't worry, even with that little action of yours, it will be counted as mountains of rewards. Abshiru wa saddidu. And make sure that you are on the straight path. You're making the correct thing by following the steps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he said, wa qaribu. If you're not capable of going as straight as possible, then make sure that you are close. Wa qaribu. So abshiru wa saddidu wa qaribu. The companions were a lot better in situation than when the Prophet of Allah said to them, if you knew what I know, you would have cried a lot. And you'd have laughed but little. Ibadallah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he had said that eloquent speech, one of the companions who were listening, he said, Messenger of Allah, ka'annaha maw'idhatu muwadda. It looks like that this is the counseling, the admonishing, the advice of a one or a person who's about to depart, is about to die. And it was the case, Prophet of Allah, a few months after this khutbah, he died. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam now, he's giving the admonishing for this ummah. So the ummah would adhere to it and pay attention to it. They will not put it behind their back. They will not keep a closed eye. Look at that admonishing. Investigate it. Study it. Wallahi, there is the triumph of this ummah in this life and the hereafter. If the ummah followed just that eloquent speech of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He said, Alaykum bi taqwallah. That's number one. Hold on to the taqwa of Allah. A command from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is the command of the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala to his Prophet and the prophets before him to make their people to have taqwa of Allah. وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have given the prompting the ones before you and yourself. And ittaqu Allah, but you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You fear Allah azza wa jal in the open and the inward, outward and inwardly. You fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the fear that would result in the deeds and the actions. The fear that will give you the success in this life and the hereafter. For verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Fear Allah so that you could be successful in this life and the hereafter. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Fear Allah that you might get the mercy from the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the taqwa which when you do the actions of obedience, you do it with the knowledge. You're hoping for the reward from Allah. And the taqwa is to abandon the sin with the knowledge, fearing the punishment of Allah. This is the taqwa. So the taqwa makes you straight away fear Allah. You're about to commit a sin. You remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. That's the taqwa of Allah. This is the taqwa which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it the salvation on the hereafter. وَنُنَجِّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا. And always we give salvation to the ones who are fearing Allah. Ibadallah. Taqwa Allah is not a word that you're saying it. It's not something you learn it like this. This is something that goes into the heart. This is one of the actions of the heart. And it would result into the limbs. You'll find the person who's having the taqwa of Allah as far as he can from displeasing Allah Azza wa Jal. You'll find the person who's making taqwa of Allah as close as possible from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had commanded him. This is the taqwa. This is what we want. Alaykum bi taqwa Allah. So if you have taqwa Allah, what else you want? Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, wa sam'i wa ta'ah. And to hear and obey. To whom I hear and obey? To my commanders, to my leaders, to the ones who have been positioned as a leader, a president, a prince, a king, whom I've given my pledge, whether I've given it with my own hands, whether I was born and he was the king, I have to submit to that leader. And that submission is part of the taqwa. So why the Prophet ﷺ would emphasize such a thing? That's what we're going to be discussing, inshallah, in our second part of our khutbah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وعلى من تبع هداهم إلى يوم الدين. عباد الله، the person when he's about to die, he will give what is so important to his family. He will tell them what they need to hold on in order to get the salvation. And that was the counseling of the Prophet of Allah before he died. He's telling his ummah to have the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If I want to speak about the taqwa, that's about a lecture and about a lecture and after a lecture. The taqwa of Allah is all the deen, is all of it based upon the taqwa of Allah. But the Prophet ﷺ wanted to emphasize something after the taqwa of Allah, which is from the taqwa of Allah, that it will be the disease of this ummah. And it is what the Prophet ﷺ had already been inspired by the Almighty, what is going to take place years after years. When the people forget what are the commands of Allah and the commands of His Prophet, they're going to go back to this point. وَالسَّمْعِ وَالطَّاعَ. If you look at the history, and they say history repeats itself, and it does repeat itself. How many times we had in this ummah, in the history of this ummah, downs. And those downs, when you reflect upon them, and you see what are the reason, you will come to the conclusion that is part of that saying of the Prophet of Allah, وَالسَّمْعِ وَالطَّاعَ, to hear and obey. When we come to the Imam, and we pray behind the Imam says, Allahu Akbar. What is your idea about a person he would say, I'm not going to say Allahu Akbar? What is your idea about a person who says Allahu Akbar before the Imam? What is your idea about a person who says Allahu Akbar well after he recites the Fatiha and he goes to ruku'? He's disobedient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala trains us 5 times a day at least to adhere to the command of the Imam. إِنَّمَا جُعِلَ الْإِمَامُ لِيُؤْتَمَّ بِهِ. This is the university where the Muslim should be graduated from. If you are with the Imam, with his movement, then you should be the same thing outside with your leader, the great Imam, Al-Imam Al-Akbar. The ones whom you have given the pledge, the ones whom the scholars had said in all their aqidah, Al-Imam Al-Tahawi, he says, وَلَا نَرَى الْخُرُوجَ عَلَىٰ أَيْمَّتِنَا وَإِنْ جَارُوا وَلَا نَرَى الْخُرُوجَ عَلَىٰ وُلَاتِ أَمْرِنَا وَإِنْ جَارُوا. We will never deem it to be fit or to be correct to make a coup against our leaders, even if they're to be tyrant leaders. This was the sayings of all the scholars in the books of the Aqidah. They will say also, وَلَا نَدْعُوا عَلَيْهِمْ. We don't supplicate against them. وَلَنْ يَنْزَعُوا يَدًا مِّن طَاعَةٍ. And we do not pull the hand away from the pledge. We don't make a coup and line up against the leader because he put the price of tomatoes £2 up or the cucumber £2 up or he made a deal with the enemies. It is not right, ibadallah. The leaders of a Muslim, regardless how bad he is, as bad as Al-Hajjaj, who had killed 120,000 from the Muslims. Even if it was the Hajjaj, I'm not allowed to make a coup. What the coup does, no safety, no security, killing will be taking place everywhere. Ask those people who had tried it already in their countries. Ask the Libyans, ask the Syrians, ask all those people who had called it a triumph. What happened at that time? Look and listen to what they're saying today. I wish the time can reverse back and I will put my hand with that tyrant leader whom I have spent my family in killing and my tribe in killing to remove that person. And then I ended up with what? With more killing and no safety. What was Ibrahim's dua alayhi salam? رَبِّ اجْعَلْ هَذَا الْبَلَدَ آمِنًا مُطْمَئِنًا. O Lord, make this land, Mecca, to be amn, وَطْمِئْنًا, to be safe and secure. That was the supplication of Ibrahim alayhi salam. That was the supplication of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَنْ أَصْبَحَ آمِنًا فِي سِرْبِهِ, معافا في بدنه عنده قوت يومه فكأنما حيزت له الدنيا بحذافيرها. If the person wakes up, he's safe in his neighborhood. He's not worried that somebody's gonna kick the door onto him and rape his wife and kill his children. He's happy because he's in safety. He is in safety that if his neighbor had done something to him, there's got a court to go on or police to go on to and complain. No chaos. For verily, the first thing that the Prophet of Allah uttered, "Man asbaha aminan fi sirbi," then healthy in his body. The person is healthy, and he knows how much precious to be healthy when he gets ill, and he could see the crown of honor on every healthy person walking, yet he's not able to walk. Ask the people in the patients, ask the people in the hospitals, they'll tell you the ni'mah, the blessings of being healthy. Then the third one, وَعِنْدَهُ قُوتُ يَوْمِهِ, he's got the provision, the food for his one day. Amongst us, who is that person who hasn't got the food not just for one day, for a whole month? He's made the shopping for the whole year. Not one day, akhi, just one day. You have the shopping for one day, the food of one day. It's like you have whole world under your possession. You are the king of your time. If you have the safety, you have the health, and you have the food for the day. So what are these people fighting in those countries? Are they fighting for the food of the day? I got plenty of that. And that is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took the pledge from the companions. Bayana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The companions, we have given the pledge to the Prophet of Allah, ala sam'i wa ta'ah, to hear and obey, fil manshati wal makrah, whether in the good times or the bad times. Wa ala athara, even if the kings and the monarchs takes the money to their own family, to the king family, to the royal family, and they take in everything and they're leaving nothing to the people, still I cannot pull out the pledge. So what are these people fighting for? For the establishment of the deen? La wallah, the deen was there, they could pray, nobody's stopping them, no king is telling them, I'm gonna kill you, cut your neck if you pray or you show yourself into the masjid. Nobody's saying that. You could pray, but you're after more money. That's what you are after. After the dunya, and you lost the dunya in the akhirah. وَالسَّمْعِ وَالطَّاعَ, that's what the Prophet ﷺ had commanded us, to hear and obey, even if this person is from a different country, from a different color, from a different language, from a different tribe, from a different race. وَإِنْ تَوَلَّى عَلَيْكُمْ عَبْدٌ حَبَشِيٌّ بِأَبِي أَنْتَ وَأُمِّي يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Look at what the Prophet ﷺ is saying to you. He is predicting what is going to happen. Even if that person who is going to take the leadership, he is not speaking the same language, he is not from the same color, he is not from the same race, he is limping, got one eye, he's got one nose, well, one half a nose. It doesn't matter. He's your leader. And don't you think I'm fit for it? If you say that, this is when the disaster takes place. This is when the killing takes place. Prophet ﷺ, he said, بَيْنَ يَدَيِ السَّاعَةِ الْحَرْجِ, before the day of resurrection, harj will take place. Messenger of Allah, what is harj? A lot of killing. Oh, you're killing one another. Messenger of Allah, still we got our brains with us, killing one another. He said, no, people's brain will be taken out. وَإِنَّهُ لَتُنْزَعُ عُقُولُ ذَلِكَ الزَّمَانِ, the brain of those people, they're going to be taken out. They're going to be in spare parts. They're not going to be in their heads. And the people think they are upon something. وَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ وَلَيْسُوا عَلَى شَيْءٍ. They think, mashallah, they are the scholars running the show. They are the ones who are running. They want the scholars to follow them, not to follow the scholars. Allahu al-musta'an. They want the scholars to follow BBC and TCC and CNN and all of that. Where is our brains when the killing is taking place? How many thousands of people is going to take place until we wake up? Subhanallah. What is happening? As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, and on the day of resurrection, before the day of resurrection, the people start killing one another. كَأَنَّهُ يَذْبَحُ دَجَاجَ, he's like slaughtering a chicken. And you've seen that maybe on YouTube, how a Muslim slaughter, Allahu Akbar, another Muslim, just like he slaughters a chicken. And this is the triumph. This is the Islam. Wallahi, this is not the Islam. Islam got nothing to do with it. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, عَلَيْكُمْ بِتَقْوَى اللَّهِ, والسمع والطاعة، وإن تولى عليكم عبد حبشي رأسه رأس زبيبة فإنه من يعش منكم فسيرى اختلافا كثيرا. Who's amongst you gonna live is gonna see a lot of split, a lot of differences. This person is upon Sufism, this is upon every ism. Every person has got his own way. Lots of differences. This is the disease. What is the cure, Messenger of Allah? Prophet of Allah, he said, عليكم بسنتي. Hold on to the sunnah of the Prophet of Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah the Almighty says about him, وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. What the Prophet of Allah commanded you to do, then do it. And what the Prophet of Allah told you not to do it, don't do it. مَنْ أَطَاعَنِي فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهُ وَمَنْ عَصَانِي فَقَدْ عَصَى اللَّهُ وَمَنْ أَطَاعَ أَمِرِي فَقَدْ أَطَاعَنِي وَمَنْ عَصَى أَمِرِي فَقَدْ عَصَانِي. He who obeys the Prophet of Allah, he said, obeys me, the Prophet had obeyed Allah. And he who disobeyed me had disobeyed Allah. And he who obeys my leader, then he had obeyed me. And he disobeyed my leader, he disobeyed me. Ibadallah, the matter is serious. عليكم بسنتي. Hold on to the sunnah of the Prophet of Allah. This is the path to salvation. This is the path to supreme success. The sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibadallah. Then he says, وَسُنَّةِ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ الْمَهْدِيِّينَ مِنْ بَعْدِ. Not only the sunnah of mine, but there is a sunnah of the rightly guided Khalifa. After my death, they will be upon my sunnah. Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, those are the great companions. They are upon the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. عَضُّ عَلَيْهَا بِالنَّوَاجِذِ. Bite onto it with your molars. That means cling onto it. Don't detach yourself away from that sunnah. Then he says, after that, قَالْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَمُحْدَثَاتِ الْأُمُورِ. Be aware of all innovations. This is the start of my khutbah. إِيَّاكُمْ وَمُحْدَثَاتِ الْأُمُورِ. Be aware of all innovations in religion. The innovation in religion will take you to the kufr and the shirk of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any innovator in the deen who says that this is something, I think it's correct, then he's either one of the three, putting himself as a god. So, أَمْ جَعَلُ لَهُمْ شُرَكَاءَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he says that they made partners. شَرَعُ لَهُمْ. That they have made for them legislation. مَا لَمْ يَأْذَنْ بِهِ اللَّهِ. What Allah did not permit them to do. So he's making himself as a god. Or if he's not, then he's accusing the religion to be not complete. For verily Allah, he said to his prophet, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ. Today I have completed for you my religion. So the religion is complete. So when you say that this is good in religion, you're accusing the religion is not complete. If it's not that case, then the third case, which is even worse, you are accusing the Prophet of being a treacherer, a betrayer, because he did not convey what you have just said. He had fallen short to tell us what you just came up with. And that's even worse. How dare you that you say this is good and the Prophet of Allah did not say it's good. And that's why in every khutbah of the Prophet of Allah, when he ascends the pulpit on the day of Jumu'ah, what does he say? وَكُلُّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالٍ. And every innovation is a misguidance. Somebody comes from nowhere, he says, not every bid'ah, every bid'ah is dalala. You're opposing the Prophet, أخي. كُلُّ بِدْعَةٍ. Every Arabic, كُلُّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالٍ. Every innovation in religion is a dalala, a misguidance. And you are coming saying, no, this is not dalala. And that's the disaster. Ibadallah, if you start to innovate in your religion, you're going to drift away. And drift away until there will be no religion. You start with a small bid'ah and you end up with a big bid'ah. You're small with a bid'ah and then you end up with a shirk in Allah Azza wa Jal. Those people who are rotating around their graves, asking Badawi or Jilani. Those people who are sacrificing animals to Badawi and Jilani. Why do they do that? Because they have a wrong aqidah regarding the asma' and the sifat, the beautiful names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If they knew in their heart properly that Allah is the one who is the creator, Allah is the one who knows the ghaib, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has the absolute ghaib, they will never worship or slaughter to Jilani and Badawi.
But because they have wronged their aqeedah, they ended up to do this. This is their bid'ah. وَكُلُّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. We ask ourselves, are we on the whole religion of the Prophet of Allah? Are we on the path that the Messenger of Allah had drew to his companions? If we are, alhamdulillah. If you are not, let's start from today. Let's start from this moment. Correct our ibadah. Am I praying like the Prophet of Allah? Ask myself, did you learn that prayer from the books? Or did you just see somebody had taught you and he's not even a knowledgeable person? You saw your parents who are ignorant as well. Did you learn the prayer? Did you come to the class to learn a prayer? Or did you just, I'll just put myself with the people and do what they want? No, akhi. You need to learn so you could be upon the Prophet ﷺ's path. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا ممن يستمع القول فيتبع أحسنه.